Hi, everybody. So can I say just a couple of words, and then I'm really happy to take everybody's questions. And just to start with, my son Hamish is here, and, you know, probably wouldn't be here if I didn't make him. But
true.
But the reason I asked him to come is because when I decided to seek the BC Liberal leadership almost 7 years ago now, and when I decided to do it, I didn't think it was going to be easy to do, but I did decide to do it because I wanted Hamish to see me in public life, wanted to see me trying to do good in the world and do public service. So he's been a part of this journey with me the whole time. You can try and smile. and it's been an incredible journey for 6.5 years as premier now. I think we accomplished a lot. We've got the fastest growing economy in the country, 200,000 jobs putting people to work, and 5 consecutive balanced budgets. We got Site C going, putting thousands of people to work there. We negotiated labor agreements that were affordable with the public sector, the longest period of labor peace with the teachers. And we have reduced the number of children in care by a third. Every year, more children have been adopted in our system. We have created the Great Bear Rainforest. We concluded treaties and signed over 450 agreements with First Nations. We are the leading edge of reconciliation with First Nations of any province in the country, bar none. And we created the Single Parent Employment Initiative, which has put thousands of parents back from welfare into work. So, I mean, that's just a list of some things off the top of my head, I guess. And I would say I'm proud of all of them. But, you know, as a leader, you know when it's your time to leave. And this was my time to leave. So our party and our caucus, I know, are going to have the energy of a leadership race. They're going to be excited about it. They'll learn, I think, a lot from that about how to be in opposition and how to stand up for the principles that we believe in. And I really wish them all the best. So thank you. I guess I'll never see any of you ever again. I'm happy to take your questions before I leave you.
Great.
For the rest of your lives.
So Anish has a microphone, so just wave at me if you want to ask a question. We'll start with Richard from CBC.
Did you come to the conclusion that your party could not win an election with you continuing on as leader?
No. I decided it was time for our party to renew. And it's going to be an adjustment for our party and our caucus to learn what it is to be in opposition. They're going to have to, you know, find some new energy. And I felt like it was the time for them to do this. I don't think there's going to be an election in the fall, so why not get it out of the way? And it was the right time for me. I mean, a leader needs to know when it's time to go. There is nothing worse than seeing politicians hanging on because they feel like they're irreplaceable. Nobody's irreplaceable. I'm not.
Did you fail people of Metro Vancouver by not properly addressing transit, housing affordability, and childcare?
Well, I think, you know, there are only two things that the government can do to really affect housing affordability in the Lower Mainland. One is to get the mayors to build more houses, to approve more houses to be built. And the second is slow the economy down so people stop coming to the Lower Mainland and buying houses. Ultimately, those are the only two things that you can do. So we'll see what kind of progress the new government's able to make with those, I guess. But I would say, you know, we as a government and me as premier decided we wanted to keep people working, pay off the debt for our kids, and spend other people's money responsibly, not money that we didn't have. And, you know, this is a great place to live. And people from all over the world want to live here, and why wouldn't you? Look at this.
So let's go to Maria and then to Camille from CP, and then we'll go up back as well.
Hi, just two questions. What are your future plans now?
I'm going to get Hamish to do his homework because I'm going to have more time to do that. Grade 11 is a busy year. I'm going to maybe get some gardening done in the short term. I don't know, though. In terms of the substantive part of your question, I don't have a plan yet.
And the fact that you've now left also your legislature seat, leaving the NDP with a true majority, at least until there's a by-election, any feelings on that?
Well, I think they're, you know, if leaving them, diminishing our numbers in the House is a big problem if they're likely to, if there's likely to be an election. I don't think there's any likelihood of an election in the fall. And so part of my decision was figuring out, all right, when is the best time for this to happen? Is it 2 years from now when an election is more likely, or is it now when it's least likely? And I really felt it was best for our party and for the province to get it out of the way as soon as we could.
So we'll go to Camille from CP, then Ian from The Globe, and then Marcella from News 11:30.
Hi, Camille.
Hi. Two questions, if I may, please. Lots of speculation about who's going to take over your job. Who would you like it to be?
I would like it to be the person the party wants. I mean, I don't, I'm not going to try and influence that in any way. I'm going to vote because I'm a member. Hamish is going to vote because he's a member. But we're, I mean, I'm not going to get involved in any of the campaigns. I just, this decision belongs to the members of our party, and they will make the best decision, I think.
What was it like for you as a mom to tell your son about this big decision that you made?
He was really happy, I think. Were you?
Sort of. I don't know. I feel like this is your press conference. I'll let you.
Okay.
But how did you feel?
I felt a little relieved. I'm sorry, I was really not ready to speak today. I didn't even know I was going to be coming here. Yeah, so 6.5 years. It's been a long time. She's been premier for most of my life that I can remember. So I think it's going to be an interesting change. It's going to be really... It's going to be cool. It's going to be fun.
Nice. Yeah. Yeah, so we'll get more time. We've already bought how many theater tickets have
we
had?
Yeah, we're going to go see a lot of theater. That's
how many did you buy today?
Well, we got 2 subscriptions to the Arts Club season, so I'm pretty happy about that.
So we're going to go see a lot of shows, a lot of theater. And I just, it's going to be so nice for me to, one of the things I know is that when kids are teenagers, my parents thought this, you could kind of give up on parenting because they're older. I think that when kids are teenagers, it is the most important time for parents to pay attention, and because kids are really getting started in life.
So we'll go to Ian and then Marcella.
Ms. Clark, did you go to Penticton intending to leave, or was this a decision that sort of emerged in the moment as you sort of arrived and took a sense of where things were?
Ian, looking back, I knew in my heart from election night that I was, it was time for me to leave in my heart. And that feeling grew, you know, as the lieutenant governor called on John Horgan to form the government. I was going to resign as leader that night, but I felt like I had a responsibility to get the party, you know, get the caucus into the opposition offices and kind of get us organized. I didn't want to leave in the midst of chaos. So I stuck around, but it was really in Penticton, and it was kind of that night in Penticton that in my head I decided it was time to go, and my head caught up with my heart, and I took a walk along the lake shore on Friday morning, and I knew it was time to leave, and it's the best time to leave. It's great for me, but I wanted to leave at a time that was good for my party. And, you know, I talked to the caucus the day before. I asked them all, did they want me to stay? Did they want me to go? Every one of them asked me. Every single person in the room asked me to stay. But I have been looking that group of people in the eye for 6.5 years. And I just knew that even though they didn't know it, it was time for me to leave and time for us to renew.
There's a follow-up. You were at the helm for a throne speech that sort of shows, as I said, some sympathy for NDP policies and such. Do you think your successor will be free to break with that and to go in a new direction as things unfold whenever that new leader becomes leader and has to fight the NDP?
My successor will be able to do whatever she or he chooses to do without me interfering in that. And they're going to do that with the caucus and with the party. I look forward to seeing what they choose to do. I wouldn't say though that I support NDP policies, because you know we may support some of the same principles Our government has invested way more in childcare every year since I've been premier, for example. But we want to make sure those things get done right. And so, for example, $10 a day daycare, that's not a good plan. But there is a good plan that we can come up with to expand daycare for people. So, I mean, I guess I take some issue with the point that we agree with them on some policies. We have absolutely stuck with all of our principles. And we wouldn't be able to afford to do all these things if we hadn't stuck with our principles all these years.
Let's go to Marcella from News 1130.
I just wanted to ask you, have you had a chance yet to meet with Linda Kayfish to apologize to her personally? And if not, are you planning to sometime this summer?
I have asked her for meetings several times, but she hasn't accepted.
Follow-up to that, are you going to reach out to her again before you leave at the end of the week?
I am done with public life.
Great. I think Jenny from Daily Hive.
Thanks. Given everything that you've been through in politics over the last few years, I mean, you've brought Hamish on stage with you a lot. Would you advise him to go into politics?
Oh, geez. What he does is completely up to him. You know, my son has, he's a talented young man. I think he has a great future in theater. So.
Anyone else?
I'm looking forward to being a stage mom.
Okay, one last one, and then get out of here.
Christy, are you completely ruling out any future in politics?
I'm not planning on going back. That's for sure. You know, to me, politics isn't a happy job. Like, it's not a fun job, really. It's a fulfilling job, though, and it's really interesting, and I love doing it. And to me, life is not about being happy, though. Life is about doing service for others. And so I'm going to find a way in my next career to do service, to continue to do service, to try and make other people's lives better. Because to me, that's the path to happiness. But I don't see that being in politics anymore. I think being Premier of British Columbia for 6.5 years was such a privilege. I don't think I can get a better, more interesting, more fulfilling political job.
Thanks very much, everyone.
All right. Thanks, everybody.